Hey, it's that time again for Tubers High Score Challenge Series, and this time it's the arcade version of the NES Classics versus Super Mario Bros. And of course, as always, one credit and no more, naturally. As well as default settings, which actually were the stipulation this time by the person who chose the game, which was Johnny Hart. So, yeah, showing that, of course, as always. Anyway, let's just get it going here. Of course, as I do anymore, I'm doing this after the fact, which is very good in this one because I did not have a fun time. Let me put it this way, there was a lot of minor mistakes which added up to big ones that kind of compounded throughout the... as it went on. That's the best way I can explain it. I don't know. It just wasn't a good time with this one. Which sometimes I've noticed with this game, I mean, it doesn't really matter that this is the Versus version for the arcade or the NES. It's pretty much the same game. There are a few differences, I just can't remember them from memory, so sorry. But it doesn't really matter which one it is, that sometimes, some days I notice I have a lot, I do a lot better, and other days I don't know. But I'm disappointed in myself considering what the game is. I should have done better, I think. I don't know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it's harder than I usually think it is, and I don't know. But I'm not happy with it, is what I'm saying. Anyway, some of this did actually go well, and a few things actually went a little better than I thought. I mean, for example, one thing I don't like is I didn't get as many pulls for 5,000 points, which was one of the important things I really wanted to do. And this whole thing here, I pretty much just decided to play the same as normal as I would, because as I said to Matt Metropolis, who told me, he usually does tell me what the games are when they come up and who chose them and all that. As I said to him, not once in my entire life since I first played the original Super Mario Bros. Here, and again, it doesn't matter that this is the arcade version, I never once ever considered, for even kicks, playing it for score, seeing what kind of score I get. So I wouldn't even know what the best thing to do is, and as I also said, there's really only, I don't know what else I'm supposed to talk about with Super Mario Bros., that's why I'm rambling on like I am about this. But there's only three things I can think to do. Either you try to go as fast as hell as you can to get the most amount of points for like the end bonus thing and all that, and try to get as high as you can on the poles and not mess up as much. Go slow, but still obviously make it to the end before the time runs out, and kill as many Goombas, Koopas, whatever else as you can for points, which are not worth a lot, and collect as many coins as you can. Or the third way is kind of a combination of both, which is sort of what I ended up doing. But I didn't go as fast as I usually do because it just wasn't working out for me, because I was kind of second-guessing myself, when normally I just go as fast as I can and I don't think about it. See, that's something that annoys me. It looks like to me I should have got 5,000, but apparently not. That happens a few more times. And it's just annoying. It's something that's always bothered me with this. I guess it's like a micron off, and it's not enough, so it decides, oh, you can't have the 5,000 points, which 5,000 points goes a long way in this game, let me tell you. I mean, don't get me wrong, I like the 2,000 points. It's a lot better than what you get if you get lower on there, which I screw one particular one up, and you'll say I don't even get 1,000 on that one. But, I mean, damn, I want that 5,000 points. I was banking on it. I did mention this because I'm going on about this and I missed my chance to say it, but I had kind of like a target score for each section, and that's the way I could see if I was doing right or not. And because I messed up the other one, I didn't get it for this one, which before this one started, which the second one I was supposed to get 50,000 points. I mean, I get a little bonus, that's fine, a little higher than that. But, see, I got 5,000 here, and that's good. But because I messed up on this previous one, this is what I meant by compounding it, I didn't get to my goal of 70. But on the first one, I did get to my goal of 26,000, see? It froze everything out of whack, so that kind of messes with me, too. Now, another important thing I really want to do, which I managed to do here, which I had to restart so many times like any of these I do for the series, more than I should. Let's just put it that way, you don't want to know the actual number. I don't want to lose the Fire Flower power-up in this stage now. You can figure what you want about this, but I've always liked the Fire Flower a lot. It's pretty much my favorite power-up in any Mario game. I don't know, I just like being able to shoot things at a distance. It works well for me. I'm better with it than anything else, and it works well for me. So, I want to ride it as much as I can in this, much like the shotgun in Doom. Stick with what works, it's what I know. Like I said, my idea was pretty much just to play it the same as I normally would, because it's not like some other stuff where I actually can come up with some alternate way to play it. Which, by the way, anytime I did try to deviate and play this some other odd different way than how I've done for so many years, it doesn't go well for me. It really doesn't. It's also why I didn't do as well in general or go as far as I usually do because of that. But, I don't know. I usually take my time a little bit more in some parts. I went too far over and I couldn't get the last box, which I was banking on getting that damn coin. Anyway, there is one particular part, I might as well mention this right now, even though we're not near it yet. There is one thing that kind of makes me like this run, even though I said I don't much, is a particular kill I get with a Koopa on the bridge. And I don't know, I don't know why that happened, by the way. I'm not used to playing this game on an emulator. It doesn't go well with me, you know. No matter what controller I'm using, I was using my Saturn controller here, which, you know, good D-pad. It was the best chance I had. Which is also... It did work out that way. Anyway, I intentionally wanted to go up here to get the coins, which gives me an extra life, which definitely helped me out. But, I'll admit, I've never been good at memorizing where certain things are, so that's why I kind of lost some time jumping at the boxes randomly. I knew it was one of them, I just didn't remember which one. So, that clearly screwed my time up some, and because I didn't have as much, obviously I didn't get as much as the end, so, there's things like that. I question whether or not I should have bothered. I mean, extra life is nice, and I know because of how this particular one turned out, it definitely helped me. This poll, I mess up all the time. I don't know why I do, but I usually do. I can't remember last time I got 5,000 on it, but I was hoping I would, but, no. I think I mentioned this at the beginning, but I just don't know if it's, like, I feel like I'm burned out, but, like, restarting over and over and over kind of takes it out of you. Okay, so here is the biggest question I got from myself as to, was this the best idea or decision about how to handle this part or not? I opted to pretty much kill every enemy I possibly could, as well as collect every coin I possibly could without getting my ass killed. Normally, I don't do that, so this is something I decided to change in how I normally do it, which it kind of worked out, but at the same time, I had very little time left at the end when I made the poll. It's one of the rare times I've ever heard like you're running out of time siren, and the music speeds up. So, at the same time, I'm thinking maybe I should just rush through this. Still gotta be careful, because this is one thing I do notice in the Versus version here. I'm pretty sure, from my memory, there's a lot more bloopers, and they're a lot more tenacious than they are in, like, the original NES version. Maybe I'm remembering wrong, but it seems like it to me. That's a close call right there. I got lucky. See, normally when I'm on in this game, I actually intentionally could pull off a lot of crazy jumps that are really close calls. But I don't know, I just couldn't do that this time today. I mean, yeah, it looks flashy and all, but it's also to help me, you know, get through things fast. And it's just what I'm used to and like, how I play well. Like, again, it's that sticking with what you know thing. It helps. I thought I could have killed him and get a little extra points. See, again, I didn't get 5,000. It's disappointing. It's like double disappointing. And I like it when I get fireworks because I like to think the game feels sorry for me and gives me a little extra points. It knows I'm frustrated. Okay, here's one of my favorite stages in the entire game. It's just crazy. There's a kill I get near the end of this. You'll see it. I love it. Now, I admit, I also screwed up here. I become small quite a few times, which is not the worst thing ever. I mean, if you've ever seen speedruns, speedrunners prefer to stay small in this game. Anyway, also lost levels, because there's no real point in that one to even bother trying to get the mushroom. But anyway, it's always in dickish locations, if you didn't know. Anyway, if I get another one, I also lose this one, if it works out. Anyway, this thing I'm talking about, this kind of trick shot, I might as well talk about this. I feel ashamed watching this back. Anyway, this kind of kill, I don't get... Look, you see what just happened right there? I never can get that intentionally. It's stuff like that that always happens by accident, but I love it. I wasn't trying to kill one of these cheap shapes. I was just trying to kill the damn turtle, Koopa, so it wouldn't kill me. But I ended up getting a nice little surprise, so that right there is partly what made me keep this particular recording. I love that. That was great. Me and another disappointing 2,000 points. Ugh. I know I would have had such a much better score if I got 5,000 and a few more of these. It adds up pretty good. Okay, now here's another example of personal disappointment in my performance in this run, which I don't blame you if you're disappointed in me as well. I definitely should have done better at this part, and I don't know what the hell I was thinking. That's my only answer. I should have stayed put right here, and in the middle of these, I mean, but no. I decided to keep moving. I couldn't stop my momentum in time, and that's why I died. Stupid decision number one. Stupid decision number two is coming up. Trying to rush because I'm getting frustrated. Oh, boy. Fortunately, that was the last screw up in this castle. God. Why? I don't know. Which, there was a lot more cursing involved, but I was saying the same thing out loud at myself. Why? Why did I do that? I don't know. See, this is how it always usually goes for me. I usually am small, because I messed up at some other earlier point, and I just didn't bother getting the mushroom again. And I made it through very clean and easy. Didn't really have a close call that time. Why couldn't I pull that off the first time? Again, I was asking myself that too, and I didn't have an answer. Anyway. So, this first part here in 3-1, while it doesn't go as great as it could have, I still think it went alright. So, I gotta give it that. I think I could have gone through a little faster. I was being a little pedantic in this one. Not intentionally, though. I think it was just because of what screw-ups happened before this. I don't know. I think I was, as far as I remember, I was just really frazzled, so I was trying to be extra careful. Did impact my time. So, there's another thing I'm not too happy with. I don't know why I did that. Couldn't give you an answer. There's no reason for it. I don't know why. I'm not afraid of the Hammer Brothers. I actually do really well against them. I don't know. I should have just got my damn finger off the button. Anyway, fortunately, take all that out. This life I'm about to get pretty soon is the saddest. I can't even call it like a bad mistake, but it's just sad. As soon as I get it practically, I lose it. But because I got the extra life when I did, that does mean I was able to continue on a little longer than I wouldn't have been able to. I love that too. That was intentional. I got that Goomba coming back, and I figured, well, why the hell should I bother going for it? Might as well use a frickin' shell, right? Makes it easier. I like it when that works out. It doesn't work out as often, and this kind of is annoying. Son of a bitch. Why didn't I hit the button sooner? Anyway. Another 2,000 points. I swear. The polls. If only I got the polls correctly, a few other ones, I would have hit what I was hoping to get when I realized how this was going. 200,000, but I didn't. Came close, kind of, but oh well. So, and here's where it all goes to shit. Boy. If you want to see how to play Super Mario Bros. Well, don't watch me. Or at least don't watch me when I'm kind of burned out. Again, why did I do that? I don't know. Things I could have easily avoided. And if I did... Now, the last death that's about to happen at the end here. Something that technically I thought I avoided. I don't know. I guess this is another one of those cases where it was just a micron below or above where I had to be. And decided, nope, you're not going to have it. So it decided to bump me just a little bit and send me right into death. These friggin' turtles. Nintendo knew exactly what the hell they were doing when they put those bastards in those kind of tight boxes where they just bounce back and forth like a freaking pinball. Ugh. It's weird too, because usually I never have a problem there. I was so happy I got that 1,000 points though. I saw the chances like, oh wait, I know this. I cannot screw this up. Fortunately I didn't. Here it is, right here. Yeah, I should have slotted it in there. That's what I usually do. I did it the same way as I always do. I played it back too, looking at it. I got no clue what happened there. I guess I just screwed up on my own. Whatever. Happens. Anyway, not the best score I've ever gotten, I'm pretty sure. I've lasted a lot longer than this. Without using a continue. And, yeah. It's not the best ever, I'm not proud of it, as I said. But anyway, there you go. That is my run. Thank you for watching, and I will see you later.